Good morning to one and all. I'm Christy. I'm presenting the paper on the topic awareness of credit card frauds. Can you move to the first slide? Thank you. Now we will go through these points. First, introduction of credit card. How does credit card fraud happens? Fraud related to credit cards, methods used for detection of credit card frauds, prevention of credit card frauds, and conclusion. Next. Now, what is credit card fraud? Credit card fraud is a combination of theft and fraud committed using a credit card. It is also known as identity theft. Now, first point, an offense committed by using another person's credit card without knowledge. This is credit card, using credit card number without possession of actual credit card. In case when in online transaction, when the credit number is hacked, this can be used by the fraudulent to take use of this credit card number. Stealing a person's identity is also a credit card fraud. Using another person's personal credential, act of misappropriation. This is borrowing a money in a dishonest manner, using the credit card for one's own use with no intention of repaying the debt. Next slide. Now, these are the information that are encrypted on credit cards. First one, credit card number. Credit card number is 15 or 16 digit, which is printed on the front side of the credit card towards the bottom. Next, card holder name. In this, the name of the holder, of the card, it is also printed in the front of the credit card and towards the bottom. This name should match any of the government issued ID. Next is expiration date. This is also in displayed in the front of the card, and it has year the credit card expires. CVV or card verification value. This is the three-digit number which is found in the backside of the credit card near the signature box. In American Express card, this CVV has four digits, which is printed on the front side of the credit card. Next is signature of the card holder. This is also found in the backside of the credit card. Next is magnetic strip, which is the data stored by the modifying the magnetic tiny iron-based magnetic particles on the band of magnetic material on the card. This magnetic strip contains information such as credit card number, name, expiration date, service code, CVV, etc. in the first two tracks, and in the third track, the country code or the currency code is also found. Next is hologram. This hologram helps us to do the payment processing in the secure manner. If hologram is present in the credit card, it can be it represents that it is a valid card or the card is legal. This hologram is made up of several layers of images which is placed on top of one another. These images are taken at different angles. Next is microchip. This also helps the consumer with the additional security. Can you move to the next slide, please? How does credit card fraud happen? A consumer may reveal his credit card details to unfamiliar individuals. In this case, there are chances where the credit card fraud can happen. Next is when a card is lost or stolen. This can be used by someone who gets it to buy or purchase something from your card. Next is taking the information from the mail. Like account number, account name may be hacked from your mail also. Next is counterfeit credit cards, duplicating of credit cards and using it for their personal purposes. Next is when credit card receipts or statement receipts are disposed in the dustbin or in public places. These receipts can be used by the fraudster to make fraudulent changes or to make take the money from your bank accounts. Thieves may hack the companies with whom you have had transactions, and then this can be used to engage in data breach. Next is when a stranger may send you an email and ask you to visit a fraudulent website. There you are tricked to provide with your card number, which thus can be misused by the criminals. Next slide, please. We will discuss about different types of credit card frauds. First one is false obtains card. In this scam comes to fraudulent credit and transaction without possessing physical card. Next, card never fraud. This card has never reached after touching from the bank. This happens.
Christy,
when,
I guess your internet is low. The voice is breaking.
Sorry, sir.
Christy, can you start presentation on this from this slide? Like type of credit card fraud?
Yes, sir. Here we discuss different type of card frauds. First one is false application fraud. Here, the fraudulent actors may impersonate a genuine customer by using the stolen counterfeited document to obtain the credit. Next is card notification fraud. Here, the scam attempts to fraud card transfer.
I think, Christy, there is some network issue at your end.
Next is this card never.
Christy, I think
card never arrived fraud. Am I audible, sir?
Yeah, you're audible, like, but other system which is on in your room is echoing the voice. So you can turn off the speaker of that system.
Okay, sir. Am I audible now?
Yes, better than earlier.
Okay, sir. Card never arrived fraud here. This means your card has never reached you, maybe after dispatching from the bank. This happens when you have applied for a new credit card or even when you have requested to replace your credit card. This at this point, the fraudulent can make use of your credit card for his own purposes. Next is account takeover fraud. Here, a malicious fraudster can or the third party can gain access to a user account credentials. Next is stealing a credit card, which is common, using lost or found credit card fraud. Next is counterfeit or skimming fraud. Here the thief may use a device known as skimmer and steals information of the credit card. When we go to the shopping mall, we slide the credit card through this device where the fraudster may take the information from your card. Next is dumpster diving credit card. And last one is fictitious fraud. In this, using a computer system or right equipment, a person may create an account. When the credit card companies try to contact the account holder after noticing that the account is not being paid, they can find out that there are no owner for the account. This is fictitious credit card fraud. Next is detection of credit card frauds. There are mainly two methods which can be used for the detection of credit card frauds. First one is rule-based credit card fraud. In this rule-based fraud detection systems, you use correlation statistics and logical comparison of data to identify the potential acts of the fraud. It is based on the insights that gained from the previous fraud incidents. The next one is machine-based fraud detection. Here, it creates the algorithms that process the large data sets. It helps to find hidden correlations between the user's behavior and likelihood of the fraudulent actions. Here, when there is a misbehavior in the user, it can be detected. Now, here I have shown the differences between the rule-based fraud detection and machine-based fraud detection. Catching of fraudulent scenarios, finding hidden and implicit correlations in data. In rule-based fraud detection, it takes more time than machine-based fraud detection. In rule-based fraud detection, verification steps are multiple, where in machine-based fraud detection, it is reduced for the verification measures. In rule-based fraud detection, long-term processing is done. In machine-based fraud detection, it is a real-time processing. Next slide, please. Now we'll discuss how to prevent the credit card frauds. First one is destroy any bill or document that has your credit card information before discarding it. Make sure you don't share your credit card details by phones or emails. Always keep your credit card safely with you. If your card gets stolen, report it immediately to the bank. Be careful while using your card for online transactions. Keep track of your cards and store the less used ones in secure place. Don't write the account number on a piece of paper or anywhere where someone can easily get it. Next slide, please. Next is shop online only from reputed companies or ones whose security measures can be verified. Review the credit card statements very carefully. If any unfamiliar transactions are noticed, report them immediately to the bank. Don't fall for phishing scams. Make sure the emails seeking the personal account information are not sent by the hackers, and try to contact the respective person in order to make sure the request is legitimate. Report the suspected fraud quickly, which will help the credit card issuer to put hold to the card and suspend the account for a while. Next. Now I'm concluding with my paper presentation. Fraud is a major problem for the whole credit card industry, which grows with the increasing popularity of electronic money transfers. To effectively prevent the criminal actions, the credit card issuers should consider the implementation of the advanced credit card fraud prevention and fraud detection methods. Also, the credit card holders should take special precautions not to share their personal identifying information with the unfamiliar persons or strangers. Thank you.